Hello friends, today we have a guest, the wireless version of the Aqara switch, model H1M, with one button. Interestingly, switches of this series are available in 6 colors, but when it comes to AliExpress, they are only available for wired models, which come in 1, 2, and 3 button variants. However, for some reason, the wireless versions are only available in black, and have been for quite some time. This is the color of our review hero today. Another point, the single button versions are not often purchased because the price difference with the two button version is minimal, and it offers many more actions, which is probably why, as of the video release date, this version is the only one that still lacks official support in zigbee2 MQTT, but we will solve this problem. For those who want to know more, I will leave a link in the video description with a list of my reviews of various Aqara switches, starting from the very first series up to the newest, Z1 and Z1 Pro. Before we start, as usual, please like this video so that more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Device type, wireless logic switch. Model, Aqara H1M WXKG21LM. Interface, Zigbee 3.0. Power supply, CR2032 battery. Size, 86 by 85.8 by 12.25 mm. Operating temperature range, from 0 to 40 degrees Celsius. Relative humidity, from 0 to 95%. The device comes in the manufacturer's typical white box, a design used for devices intended for the domestic Chinese market, which is also indicated by the numerous hieroglyphic inscriptions. On one of the side panels, the technical parameters I just mentioned are indicated. Included with the device, apart from the switch itself, is a large piece of double-sided tape, which can be used to attach it to a surface, and a small instruction manual. The instruction manual is entirely in Chinese, and is the same for both wireless versions, single and dual button. Those who follow my reviews have already seen one of the switches from this series, the wired two-button version, also in black. The front surface is mostly taken up by the buttons, in this case, one. On the upper, stationary part, the manufacturer's name is applied. In the narrow slit between it and the button, there is an activity LED, in this case centered. The wireless versions are flat, without a back. They can be installed on socket boxes and in series frames, or on any surface using the included tape. At the bottom, there are two slots for removing the back cover. On it, there are two non-slip feet and a QR code for connecting to the control system. Below it is the battery compartment with a CR2032 element, which is protected from discharge during shipping by a special insert. Comparison, from a design point of view, with the switch from the most budget series, Aqara E1. Interestingly, models in black are available for it, although so far, at least on AliExpress, only wired versions are available. And this is a more recent model, Aqara Z1, the first series with a horizontal arrangement of buttons. Let me remind you that the full list of all my Aqara switch reviews is available via a link in the description. Here's what the LED flickering looks like. It's fast and not very bright, and will only be clearly visible in the dark. We'll start the logical part of the review with the standard control system, Aqara Home, China region. I am using an Aqara M2 gateway here, by the way, the European version. The firmware is up to date. Let's go to the menu for adding new devices. To simplify the process, you can use the scanner, the button to call which is located at the top right, and then point the camera at the QR code on the back of the switch. The application will detect the gateway, I have only one, so there will be no choice and it will proceed to the connection process. To put the switch into pairing mode, you need to hold its button for about 10 seconds, until the LED flashes 3 times. A fairly common problem with connecting devices is related to a discharged battery. If you can't connect it, try replacing it with a new one. The hero of our review was correctly identified as a remote wireless switch. You can choose an icon for display on the desktop, for example, in the form of a button or a switch. It has its own plugin, but there are few settings here. Here's all that is available. You can change the name and choose another icon for the application's desktop. In the device settings menu, you can choose one of two modes. By default, the single-click mode is set, which allows for quick processing of this event. In multi-click mode, the device still waits for repeated presses. Other options are standard, a diagram of the signal quality level, firmware version check, The box came with the latest firmware, replacing an existing device, for example, one that has failed when the new one is assigned the same name, location, settings, and automations. Here I encountered an unpleasant issue. I tried several times to switch the device to multi-click mode. The settings displayed everything correctly. When changing modes, I pressed the button to bring it out of sleep mode. But still, only single presses were displayed in the locks. In automations, the switch can only act as a trigger, with three options for button presses as events, but, as it turned out, in fact, only one. This is a software, not hardware, error later in the review. I'll show this. So let's hope the problem will be fixed in the updates. The Aqara M2 gateway, to which this switch is currently connected, is passed through to Apple HomeKit as a bridge. All its child devices that are supported in this system will automatically appear there. Our review hero clearly does not belong to them, as it is not present there. Therefore, any automations in which it will participate can only be created in the basic Aqara Home ecosystem. This concludes the section of my review dedicated to HomeKit. Next, I check compatibility with the European region, where I have another gateway, Aqara H1, also updated to the latest firmware. I initially went the simple route, through QR code scanning. As you can see, the accessory is not supported. I tried another method. I selected the first device from the list of supported devices, which allowed me to initiate pairing mode on the gateway. However, this too was unsuccessful, as there is no data on this model in the European region and it cannot be connected. Next in line for testing is Mihome, the Xiaomi smart home ecosystem. There are quite a few devices that are compatible in both Mihome and Aqara Home. Among the newer ones, the Aqara Z1 series of switches. As a gateway, I use the Gateway 3. In the list of supported devices, this series of switches is not present, so I choose a random device to initiate pairing mode on the gateway. But this didn't particularly help either. In Mihome, our review hero also fails to connect. Next, we'll check if the review hero can be used with the Sonoff iHost, a local smart home control center with its own Zigbee coordinator. For those who missed my review dedicated to it, you can find the link in the description. The firmware has been updated to the latest version as of the test date, 1.14.0. In the device list, I have a Sonoff Mini Wi-Fi USB switch remaining from previous tests, which, by the way, works quite stably on the latest firmware versions, and a Real-Link camera. Here is also the menu for adding new Zigbee devices. The connection process is standard. Hold the switch button until the LED flashes 3 times. The device was detected and connected. But that's the only good news, as what to do next with it, iHost does not know. There is no support for this switch in the current firmware version. Recently, in my videos, I talked about a budget fanless mini PC based on the Intel N4000 and installing an SSD on it. I have created a new test server based on it, where I will conduct experiments. Among other things, it has a native Home Assistant integration for working with Zigbee devices, called ZHA. As a coordinator, I am using a DIY USB Zigbee stick with firmware from the Home Assistant creators, SkyConnect. You can also find a video about it via the link in the description. The switch is detected and connected. Several objects are visible, although a sensor, which would be a source of events, is not observed here. Let's check. Indeed, there is an entity responsible for the firmware version. Although it is unlikely that it actually works, a battery-level sensor. Its status is unknown so far, but this is normal. The update may come within a day, and an identification button. As I said, there is no sensor for presses here. In some cases, it is not needed, as the presses come in the form of events and can be used in automations. But here, unfortunately, it does not work like that. There is no reaction to presses at all. The only thing that works is the identification button, which the switch's LED reacts to. But this is a small consolation. To use our review hero with zigbee2mqtt, the current version as of the testing date is 1.37.1. with a network version of Zigstar on the CC2652P2 module being used as the coordinator. As I mentioned at the beginning, the official zigbee2mqtt support currently includes all H1M models, except for the single-button wireless version, our review hero. Therefore, it needs to be connected using an external converter. For this, create an empty file in the add-in folder, which is by default named zigbee2mqtt. I named it after the model number, with a .js extension. I'm not claiming the credit for someone else's work, this converter was created directly by the author of zigbee2mqtt and is available on the project's GitHub. However, the original version has a line that prevents the converter from loading. If you remove it, everything works. You can find the link to the corrected converter in the video description. To add the created converter to the system, in the zigbee2mqtt interface, go to the Settings menu, then the External Converters tab. Then press the plus button to add a new line. Insert the name of the converter file located in the Add-in folder. Then press the Send button below. After this, a button to restart the add-in will appear in the upper right corner. This needs to be done to apply this change. Confirm and wait a little while zigbee2mqtt restarts. Then you can proceed to connect the new device. By the way, during the configuration stage, two errors appeared, but they did not recur later and did not affect the operation. Information about the switch. Thanks to the converter, it is supported, like other gadgets powered by batteries, it's an endpoint device. What we have here, a battery level sensor, which updated immediately, followed by action, the very sensor where events will be logged when the button is pressed. The pressing mode, single or multi-click, we will definitely test this now. Operational mode, in fact, has no impact on the operation of the switch. Single-click mode, when activated, only one type of event is generated by the switch, but since it does not wait for repeated presses, it is generated faster. Multi-click mode, a bit slower, as it waits for a possible second press, but in this mode, the switch can deliver three events, besides single and double, holding. For this event to occur, the button needs to be held for a few seconds until the LED blinks once. In zigbee2mqtt, the functionality is complete. From a functionality standpoint, the wireless Aqara H1M is no different from, for example, the E1. The reason to buy it could only be due to its design. For instance, if you use the wired versions of H1M or devices that match them, such as the H1 series dimmers. Personally, when buying wireless switches, and I use Aqara almost everywhere, I opt for the two-button versions because, in addition to the events when pressing each button, there are events for pressing both buttons simultaneously. That's all. I hope this video was useful and interesting for you, and I would appreciate your likes. They help promote this video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and lessons, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you will find all the necessary links to stores where you can order switches from this series, to other reviews on this topic, as well as my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home issues. If you wish, you can support my channel financially. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to all.